Hi, joyful peoples. I am from IS Joy, and I wanted to motivate you guys this February because I don't believe God is putting this on my part for no reason. Let me tell you about you. Let me tell you about you. You're an overcomer. And you want to know how you know you're an overcomer? Because things just keep happening and you feel like, can I catch a break? Can I catch a break, or it's always something? Or even though you feel God's favor, you see God's hand, you are trying as hard as you can to focus on the little things because you're still waiting for the miracle. Okay? You are an overcomer. But I want to tell you something powerful about those of you who are overcomers. Overcomers, once you overcome by constantly tapping into God, by constantly switching your mindset and starting to listen to the things of the world and change your environment and shift the whole dynamic of what you thought was worthy of your energy to things that truly are worthy of your energy. You know, you learn how to truly take the word as law, okay? And you start to take every thought captive, meaning being mindful of what you watch, being mindful of what you do, noticing patterns and cycles that are negative or leave you with a sour taste in your mouth, and doing everything in your power to switch those things around. You become limitless. You become a lethal weapon, especially knowing your Father don't play about you, because no good thing will he withhold from those who walk upright with him. That he has plans for you to prosper and not to harm you. And though the enemy comes to steal, kill, and destroy, Jesus is here to make your life abundant, okay? And God, let me tell you, God does a little bit extra. I think I've said this before, like, we like extra over here. I like extra. I believe you like extra. You know, we like extra. Who don't like extra? You go to Chipotle, they give you some extra chicken. You're going to be like, why you put that extra scoop of chicken? No, they give you that extra scoop of chicken and they don't charge you for it. And you're like, just wanted to bless me today. I don't know why she was heavy-handed on the protein, but thank you, Jesus. You know, like, you, everybody like a little extra, okay? So, understand that you have a God that does exceedingly, abundantly, more than you can ask, think, or imagine. And because of that, you will be in awe. Why am I getting emotional? You will be in awe of who you become and what God has in store for you. And all those questions of why me? Why did it have to happen to me? Why did it have to go like this? Will finally be answered, because there was something in you that God needed to build up or tear down or both in order for you to get your promise. Because God doesn't give gifts and add sorrow to it. If he knows you enter into this promise and you are not up to standard, then you'll fumble it. And then even though you asked God to it and God was faithful and gave it to you, we're human, so we might be like the Israelites, and we'd be like, God, why you give me this if you knew this was going to happen like this? Or how did I lose this, not knowing that you fumbled because you weren't prepared? And God is a good father. So when you start to ask things, or you start to dig deep, and you start to dig within God to find your purpose based off of your gifts, your talents, and the things that God keeps opening up in your life, well then, you will be shocked as to the things that start to happen And oftentimes they look completely opposite of what you prayed. You may be praying for God to restore you, but God needs to heal you before he restores you. So a lot of things need to come to light and a lot of trauma needs to be dealt with. So for you, my overcomer, I want you to know that when people overcome, they become powerful. Because now, not only did you walk this walk and get past it, and now you're on the other side, you now have the skill set to go through what you just went through and bring those out who need you. This goes back to that lesson of me, I believe I made a short where I was saying that God needs you to do what he's calling you to do, because somebody else's destiny might be in your hand. And I know sometimes that's scary, especially for those of us who don't feel equipped. But my favorite saying that I've heard was, God doesn't call the equipped, he equips the called. If you knew me maybe 3 years or more before this, me doing this, there was not anything in sight, because that I would have never thought. And honestly, just me being me, I would have never thought that God would call me of all people, because I felt the most ill-equipped. Let me tell you, if there was something to fail, I failed it. Yep. That was it. Until I chose God. And then I realized that that's not what it was. I had things in my mindset. I had things that have happened to me that I used to create a narrative that didn't belong to me. I listened to things that people said. I listened to the seeds that the enemy planted. And unknowingly, I helped him water them until God set me free. Have you ever wondered why? Or this may even be you, because this was me. Sometimes you have desires for things because you are looking for God, but you look in other places except for here. Like, you may be big on astrology. You may be big on tarot card readings. You may be big on crystals. You may be big on chakras. You may be big on energy. You may be big on just be a good person, uphold integrity, right? And make sure that you true. Like, I used to always tell people that I believe that all religions lead to the same God, because that was how I felt. Until I met Jesus. And this is not me pushing my religion or anything on anybody, nor is this me trashing any other religion or anything like that. This is me just telling you my own walk. None of them worked. Sometimes the things that I had made me far more depressed. Let me tell you, every time I staged my house, there was drama. There was drama. And I thought I was doing it wrong. Carried crystals. My anxiety tripled. Astrology, no matter what I tried, I felt like on a good day, I could be all of these signs. I mean, depending on what day it is. You get me when I'm annoyed. I might look, you know, I might look like a Scorpio. You get me on this and that. And like, I feel like we all go through all of these emotions anyways. So, you know what I mean? Like, it just, that's just what it was. So I feel like people who have that thrive and that drive for searching for God with such passion, the enemy will try and fish you out. When you look at stars, when you look at people who are musically inclined, they get attacked a lot because we know that praise is warfare. If you can attack somebody's music and imprint on their spirit without them even knowing, based off of the melody and the hymns and whatever words that are so tantalizing to your brain that you keep chanting it over and over and over again. You know how many times, what is the saying? Like, you got a song living rent-free in your mind. Why do you think these people get attacked? Because if you start to make music that inspires, uplifts, encourages, how many people would you meet? When I see people, and it's not just Christians, but people in general, when you see people who overcome drug addictions, when you see people who go to prison and end up being greater than their self, when you see the passion that they have because they have overcame whatever area it was in their life, they are a force to be reckoned with, because you learn the spirit of bounce back. When problems happen or things happen, you attack it where it is right now. You're not worried, oh, I should have done this, I should have did this. You might live there for a little bit, but you done been in so many situations that you know that it does not benefit you, it does not help you. In fact, it prolongs your agony. What we not gonna do is give the enemy any more to mess with my brain and have me answering questions that I don't know. Because what I know about my God is all things work together for my good. Holy Spirit, if I made a mistake, bring light to it and bring me a possible solution or a next step. And that's just what it is. And we trust and hold on to faith that that's exactly what's going to happen, because it is. We learn how not to freak out because it always works out. We learn that sometimes you don't need a plan B all the way through Z. Plan A is the only option, because that's God's option. And that means you trust the purpose. That doesn't mean the dynamic doesn't change. And that don't mean you ain't got to pivot sometimes. But you're ready to make that decision. You're ready to make that leap. You're ready to look foolish. Because in the end, like Noah, you're going to be looking real smart. You know, and it's crazy to me how many people just don't know. Like, let me tell you something. If you're very temperamental, if you get pissed off easily, like you are angry for a lot of things, if you got a hot temper, or people say things that may instantly just aggravate you, one, I want you to know that you have some unhealed wounds and some trauma that you need to deal with. And two, you are probably a warrior in the spirit when it comes to prayer. You ready to... That's what I learned about myself. And that's what I learned about so many people who are ready to be like, no, you not. Not today. Well, don't not today here, because that's physical. Your enemy, you know, your battle is not against flesh and blood. It's against principalities and powers and high places. So you take it, and you take your Bible, and you take your scriptures, because the Lord's word shall not return void. And you know, when you put on the full armor of God, it's the word that be slicing. That's your sword in the spirit. And that's when you start to say, you will not. Not today, Satan. I decree and declare in the name of Jesus, no weapon formed against me shall prosper. And if I resist you, you have to flee. So flee. But before you go, if the thief is caught, he has to pay back sevenfold. So drop my sevenfold and get out of the vicinity. Like, you gotta know where to channel that energy. You don't have to fight people. You love people. You appreciate people, and even broken people. If you have walked this walk, that's another thing why overcomers are so powerful. You have the power to influence people in a whole nother way because you know what it feels like to be there. You know what it feels like to be judged there. You know what it feels like to never look or to have been looked at like you will never reach here, there. So you can talk to the pain in somebody else. You can talk to the frustration in somebody else. You can talk to the insecurity and the imposter syndrome in somebody else and say, be freed. You can talk to the addiction in somebody else and say, you can overcome this. This is not your final bus stop. You will not continue down this road. You don't like it, you don't want it, then you start to bind it and work towards doing everything in your power to become the greatest version of yourself. That's it. That's why overcomers are so powerful. Overcomers are so powerful because we know what it's like. And another thing about an overcomer is that in your humility, you realize that vulnerability is your superpower. Where the world is hiding things, they don't want you to see. They don't want you to know that they failed. They don't want you to know that they ain't did this, that they ain't done that. Overcomers will tell you, let me tell you, I done failed a million times. Overcomers will tell you, yes, I made absolutely stupid decisions and thought they were smart at that time until the consequences came. Then we got better and then we did it again. So sometimes it takes a couple of times. But I am where I am now because I decided to deal with that. Because I decided to heal myself from that. Because I decided to see the light in that. Because I decided to look at the patterns in my family. Look at the patterns in my life. Look at the patterns in this season and say enough is enough. I refuse to walk in insanity unknowingly because insanity is doing the same thing over and over again and expecting a different result. I refuse to do what everybody else did and get the same result. Do what I did last week and get the same result. It ain't working. What does work? How do we shift? Or how do I stop being drawn to this certain solution? Because some of these things are spiritual. But you have to be ready to look at yourself. You have to be ready to deal with yourself. I always say you cannot heal if you do not deal. You need to deal. And then how do I constantly start to see God's goodness in each and every situation? How do I constantly start to notice how God is showing up for me and letting me know I'm on the right path? Like when I told you guys about, you know, the video about finding a godly husband, I said, there's an element of favor when God's hand is on it. Well, that's just not just for finding a godly partner. God's favor is the evidence you are on the right path. It's the evidence that God is making your path straight. It's the evidence that he's making a way out of the wilderness. Those little nuggets that he drops for you let you know that you are going the right place. And those nuggets are not like gifts because God gives gifts and he doesn't take them away. This is why you see people who can heal, who can pray, who can speak into the future, who can see all of these things in your life because they have the gifts of prophecy. They have the gifts of healing. They have these certain gifts that God gave them, and he's not going to take it from them. They were born with these gifts, but they're not using it in the right capacity. So there's not favor on it. You know, like they could do that anyways. And this is why they put that scripture in the Bible where they were coming to Jesus and they were like, but we healed in your name and we've casted out the sick and we've done all these things. And he was like, depart from me. I never knew you. You ain't got no relationship with me. You didn't walk according to my principles. You didn't inform me. You didn't even yield to the Holy Spirit. You did what you wanted to do when you wanted to do it because you knew that you could do it. That's what you did. Very different than building a relationship with me. And making me not only your savior, but your Lord. Y'all, I can go on and on and on and on and on and on about this topic because I have just been blown. Like, I was looking at this man's journal prompts and just how he overcame some things. And I was like, okay, I want to get deeper in my journaling, because I realized writing helps me heal, right? And it helps me deal with things. And then I could sit and like ask the Holy Spirit, okay, what's going on here and things like that. And sometimes I don't always have it guided to ask the appropriate questions for the Holy Spirit, or to look for the answers in the Bible, like for the, you know, like what are stories that have to do with this. I don't even know where to start, because I don't even know what's going on. I just know that I'm channeling my energy, you know, like I believe there's a book by this title. I've not read the book yet, but I want to. Your body takes the score. But that saying alone is true. There are times that I might be eating at 2 o'clock in the morning, and first of all, why are you up at 2 o'clock in the morning? And second of all, why do you think this is a good time to be frying eggs? It's not breakfast time. You don't even eat breakfast on a regular day. What is this? You know what I mean? Like, what is this? And I think sometimes we don't ask ourselves these questions. You're just like, well, I'm up. I'm just hungry. I'm just this and that. But it turns into little things. It's like, are you self-sabotaging? Does God want to speak to you and you running from him? Are you like not sleeping or getting proper rest? Is your mind truly racing? Do you need to get a journal and just let it all out? Like, what is it that is making you act out of character or act in ways that are, what is the word? I feel like lethal is kind of harsh, but like, it's affecting you negatively. Like, you are engaging in activities that are unhealthy for you subconsciously to feel what void? And these are questions you have to ask yourself, and you have to be ready to do that. And this is another reason why overcomers are so powerful, because as painful as it is, they do that. And it doesn't mean that you don't have moments, like I'm telling you sometimes, you know, and then, but you have to step back and say, well, what is that? what's going on here? Okay, we need to dig a little deeper, because this is not normal, nor is this helpful, nor is this uplifting. Like, this is not anything good. This is not anything holy. This is not anything worthy of praise. Why are we doing this? You know, and that's just the power of the overcomer. Let me tell you, you guys are overcomers. And I want you to know you are not alone. You are not alone. That is the biggest thing. We feel like we are not enough. We feel like we cannot. We feel like it's different for them. We feel like people who are successful or millionaires or start businesses or do the things that we wanted to do have 20 heads. Maybe, I don't know if that's an American saying, but I know, you know, what you call it, Africans. That's what I think my dad used to say. Be like, and the person that did it does not have two heads. Like, basically, it's not double sense. They don't have two heads. They don't have two brains. They don't have all of this extra stuff working for them. But they do know how to heal. They do know how to deal. They do know how to utilize amazing relationships and have people around them. They are okay to be the stupidest person in the room, knowing that that's the smartest decision you could ever make, because if you are amongst people who are masterminds or have reached the levels that you want to go to, they have a lot to offer you, especially if they have the same principles and character that you value. It just is what it is. It just is what it is. And then as well, they're not afraid to make steps because they're not afraid to be stupid. They're not afraid to look stupid. They're not afraid to make mistakes. Because they realize, look, I didn't fail. I either learned or succeeded. So win-win. I learned, we ain't doing that again, because it's not worth it to me. But let's try this, because they have that bounce back spirit, so they're okay to pivot. They're okay to pivot. Sometimes our mind is so like this, and God says, trust in the Lord with all your heart and lean not on your own understanding. Your own understanding says, do this. You have to go this route. These are where your skills align. This is what you have to do. God says be prepared to pivot, okay? Because this skill set can go here, here, or here. And I'm going to lead you to the best one for you. Trust the process. Do what I ask you to do. Be diligent in seeking me and taking the steps I tell you. And if you don't really know, trust me, my favor will be on it or it will scatter. And when it does, don't be disheartened and don't crumble. Bounce back and pivot. Okay, God, I don't think that was the right move. You didn't allow this to work out. Where does my favor lie? Where else could I go? What other skill sets do I have? What other things can I utilize? And this is where good, wise counsel comes from. Speak to those people in your circle. You cannot be a lone ranger in life. I don't care. I'm introverted. After a while, sometimes calling me 3 days in a row is too much. Okay, you call me 3 days in a row and I might not answer on the fourth day that you called me because I'm just tired. And it's not that I don't enjoy talking to you. It doesn't mean anything. I need me to be in a bubble. Sometimes, little mama, too, I'm gonna need you to go over here with them and give me, because that's just who I am. But I value relationships. I value those people in my corner. I am certain of who I got backing me up. I'm certain of their character. I'm certain of their values. And I can rely on them and they can rely on me. And that's what it is. People who don't need to know details, who don't need to say a whole bunch of nonsense, who don't need all of this extra stuff, but will pray with me and will encourage me and will get me back up to par, or even check on me and be like, you do this? I know you're not answering me, so I'm gonna text you. You do what I... Don't not be picking up my call because you ain't do your homework. Did you do your homework? I'm still gonna text you. You better respond. Before I call your mom. I do have friends that will probably do that. It's not gotten to that, but I can trust some of them. I can think of two now. But anyways, yes, the power of overcoming. And that's another thing. If your problem was people previously and the relationships and the way that you valued people. So yeah, let me take a sip. Trust and know that you taking this journey to walk with God and get to know him, get to know his word, let him speak to you, build that relationship with him and start to understand his character and how he speaks to you and all these other things, you will have amazing discernment. Even if your flesh wants to go somewhere, the spirit's so loud because you've trained yourself that it'd be like, girl. Mm-mm. Cute, we got this far. It's not gonna go anymore. And if you continue, because I know you want my will and you probably feel like you're not strong enough to stop, I'm gonna cut this for you. Or sometimes if you know you're strong enough and you're just playing, you're going to be real sad because he's going to let it happen and get too far. And then now you got to do it because you should have done it when it was easier. But there's that. There's that. But then once again, did you fail? No, you learned. Okay. Next time, open your eyes. That's it. All right, guys. So, if you are looking for a faith-based women's life coach, I'm your girl. Pray about it first. But you can always set up a free consultation with me. The link is in the bio. And if you love what I have here, then please consider subscribing. If not, wait until the algorithm brings us back together, girl. Okay, stay wonderful, stay positive, stay beautiful. And know you are loved. Bye.